it's Rachel. I got Resa in the house.
Hello.
How are you doing today?
I'm doing great. How are you doing, Rachel?
Doing wonderful, wonderful. Thank you for coming in, taking time to, in that traffic out there.
You know what? Today was Monday and it actually wasn't too bad.
That's good to
know.
Yeah,
it wasn't too bad at all.
That's great. That means people are probably already prepared to go on vacation. That's what I'm thinking.
They're gone already.
Yes, absolutely. So, Resa, you were just recently in this movie called 7 Dates?
Yes, I was.
Oh, how was that experience?
Oh, my God. It was so exciting to do 7 Dates with Fred and the cast members. I play Tony, which is a fitness instructor. Teaching a fitness class, self-defense class, to women. And the date, him being Kevin, was the date and me teaching the class.
Oh,
so yeah, it was pretty fun.
It has a nice little twist to it, but y'all gotta see the movie for it.
For sure.
So Resa, how did you get started like in the film and industry?
Let's see, I met Fred about a year ago. Mm-hmm. I met him and he was like, I need to work with you. Mm-hmm. And I was like, well, we should do it. And so he was pitching around some ideas. And then when this movie came available, he said, I think you would be a perfect fit for the film that I'm doing, 7 Dates. And I was like, I'm ready to jump on and get out there.
Let's go do it.
Let's do it. So.
And overall, the experience, did you just really enjoy it or have a new appreciation for the filming?
I have a great appreciation for actors. Mm-hmm. Sitting there learning your lines and learning how to use improvisation. Mm-hmm. Is that a right word? Improving.
Mm-hmm. Improving.
Yes, improving. Yes, improving. When you know, things doesn't go exactly as planned, you know, just jumping in there and kind of just using your skills and kind of just keep on going with the role. So it was interesting. It was exciting. Mm-hmm. Just can't wait to do more.
Was the role something that you had to like prepare yourself for because being a fitness instructor, or are you already in that line?
So fitness, I do fitness every day. I think that's probably why he felt like I was the perfect fit for the role. I think when he sees me all the time, I'm usually in workout clothes. He's like, do you wear that all the time? I'm like, I'm pretty much in the gym all the time. So yes, mm-hmm. But the challenging part was actually learning the line. So for me, it was a lot of repetition. Mm-hmm. It was me writing on my mirror in my bathroom.
Oh, wow.
The line. So every time I was in the bathroom, you know, you're in the bathroom a lot, getting dressed. Mm-hmm. I'm running my lines in the bathroom. Like taping them.
Memorization,
also. Right. Putting it in my sleep, playing it. So it was a lot of memorization. So I do give much respect to the actors. My lines were, I probably had about 10 lines. Mm-hmm. So I imagine the people that have more lines than that. So it's a craft and I am learning the craft so I can become a better steward of that.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely. And I know just briefly, like right before we turned on this camera, you said you used to do modeling a while back.
I did. I did modeling years and years ago, hair, fashion, and recently I got back into modeling, fitness modeling. So
nice.
I'm a fitness competitor. So I joined the wild, wild world of the National Physique Committee and competing in that arena as well.
That's really cool.
Yeah.
When does that event come up next?
My next event will be sometime next year. I was planning to compete this past May, but I broke my toe in February, so that delayed me doing that. But I say everything in timing. And so I said, God, it really actually set me back so actually I can take on this role.
Right.
And so timing is everything, and I was ready for it.
That. Timing is everything.
Timing is
God's
everything.
God's timing is everything.
Yes.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Well, that's really cool. So is there another industry that you're in, like something you do like full time right now?
Yes, I am in a health and wellness industry.
Okay.
So I'm a registered nurse by trade, but health and wellness. So I do a lot of educating on how to live a healthy lifestyle.
Nice.
Yeah.
Which everybody needs that.
Yeah, we all need that. We all need encouragement to know exactly what to do, when to do it. And if you fall off, just give yourself grace and get right back on.
Stay
in the present.
can't always be perfect all the time. So.
No, we're not perfect at no time. Mm-hmm. And giving people that, because people think you have to be perfect all the time. Mm-hmm. And just knowing that you don't, just and the soon as you realize that you are not, you're living in that present moment, mm-hmm. and that gives you the opportunity to just start all over from that moment.
That's so true. That yeah. is very true. Yeah. Those are words to live by.
Yeah, for sure.
I love those words. Yeah. So, off the record, do you hope to do some more filming in the future?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, yes. I got the acting bug. I got the acting bug. Yes, yes. Looking forward to doing more projects in the future.
Oh, I'm sure there's going to be plenty of projects coming up. I have met a lot of people in the industry in this past week that are doing production. They're either writers, producers, directors, or actors, or a little bit of all of them together.
Yeah.
And I'm just like, wow. It's like DFW has so many talents.
So many talented people, and it's mm-hmm. untapped. So I'm glad that Powerhouse Productions and Fred has actually got the bug and mm-hmm. getting the talented people out there, put them on the big screen so mm-hmm. other people can see them, mm-hmm. And then yeah, move on from there.
That's wonderful. Yeah. Well, I do appreciate you for your time.
Well, thank you so very much, Rachel, for sitting down with you, and I appreciate it.
Do you have any questions for me? I can flip the interview.
Well, yeah, a little bit. So how long have you had What's Up Dallas magazine?
What's Up Dallas magazine has been around since September of 2022, and it was a God-inspired magazine. I was already doing photography magazines as like a side hobby that turned into a business, so I was very familiar with the magazine layout. So after I started doing those, I was like, I kind of want to do something that's impactful, something that's local, and through my experience with networking events, I wanted to do something to connect the dots. A lot of people are just like, hey, Rachel, do you know somebody who does this or somebody who does this? And I was like, you know what? I don't know, but I'll find it for you. And eventually, I prayed about it, and God told me, he's like, What's Up Dallas? So I started the magazine. The name itself is an impact because it has an exclamation mark here instead of a question mark.
Yeah.
So, what I tell my readers is that the exclamation mark is to say that DFW has a lot more to offer than just the negativity that the news reports.
For sure. I agree.
And that there's a lot of talented businesses. You can find small businesses offering great quality products for way more than these, like way less than the high-end businesses that are really just trying to make it.
I'm glad that you're actually doing that. I want to plug myself. I'm in the beginning stages. Mm-hmm. It's not beginning stages because God put it on my heart mm-hmm. years and years ago, but mm-hmm. it's actually coming to fruition.
Right.
So if I can speak on it now, it's called Inspired by You. Mm-hmm. Empower, nurturing, supporting positive intentional relationships through education and unity, because I believe we are better together. Mm-hmm. And it's a more mentee mentor, because mm-hmm. I believe we should always be reaching and striving to help one another. Mm-hmm. If you're in front of me, you're grabbing my hand, I'm grabbing the person behind me, and we're grabbing each other on each other's side.
To
help each other out, because we're better together.
I believe that.
Yes.
That's wonderful. Yeah. And I can't wait to write an article about that.
Yeah.
So we can be like, hey, Resa, hey, you got your thing coming on, so let's just talk about it, let's make an article, don't worry, you're going to be one of those right there.
Oh yeah, for sure, yes.
Yeah, we'll get it all together. Y'all heard that, right? She's got a lot coming forward, so y'all stay tuned for another interview with Resa. In the meantime, go subscribe, share this video, support local business, local talents, local music, local nonprofits, and, follow everybody. Seriously, just be kind.
Yes.
And your social media accounts?
It's Resa_loves_life_fit. Because Resa loves life fit. And mm-hmm. I live by my brand.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Y'all go like and follow her right now. All right. Thank you for the love.
Thank you.
Bye.